alone. Welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over a Drake style track. Now it's not going to be how to compose the track because I did it off camera. But I want to pull out some techniques I use. So you can see a lot of audio clips. That's because I recorded these sounds off of my keyboard workstation as audio. And I didn't use a lot of MIDI. Mainly because when you use a MIDI out to control your hardware synths or your keyboard workstations, there's a little lag. And that little lag, for example, if you start out a melody, the beginning of the melody could sound faster than the rest of the melody just because there's a weird lag. So I stopped using it. I might use it for like MIDI out for complex chords or something, but right now I'm just going to do stuff by hand because the MIDI out is just not where it needs to be. Anyway, what I want to show you today is, you know, hook ideas, and we're going to get into mixing techniques as well. Okay, so you can see again, everything is audio. So I had to slice it up and move it around and get it to synchronize with the tempo. A lot of work, but that's the stuff you got to do. So this is In the Mind of Drake, more dancehall type of summer vibe. Okay, so what made this track stand out was, first, it was done by hand. So a lot of the rhythms are quote-unquote off-beat, or offset, I should say. So here's a good example. This rhythm here, if you listen to the metronome, it's slightly off. But when you have everything having its own time placement in a rhythm, it creates a nice groove. You can hear there's a subtle delay, and that subtle delay creates a nice groove for that percussion. Let's see what else is a little off track. Here's another percussion. I'm going to solo the percussion alone. Let's add in some more elements. Thank you. And notice everything has like a subtle noise to it. It's not just a clean signal. Sometimes it's a tonal noise. Sometimes it's just a white noise, like tss. Sometimes it's, you know, some flaw. But all those, you know, unique points about everything makes it really real. Instead of being so clean. And everything's done by hand. Let me see if I can find another percussive element. I think this is a synth. You probably didn't even hear the horns, so I unsoloed them. And here's another trick you can use. So here's the original bell that I did. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, you know. But then I chopped it off in the beginning to make it feel like it's a sample. So it goes 1, 2, 3. And then cut it off. Now it's running through a reverb, so it has a little bit of a tail, but because it's an audio clip and you cut it off immediately, it stops. So it feels like it's a sample. That's why I like to do certain things in audio, because when you chop it, it's gone, meaning it's gonna have that sampled, sliced feel. But it has a reverb tail because I ran it through reverb. Let me see what this track is. Another key to the rhythm is the guitar mute rhythm. And how I got that wideness, let's see. Where are we at here? I ran it through Cooper Time Cube, which created a time delay between the left and the right ear. So it feels like your guitar is spread stereo, but really it's just a quick delay with small time differences. And it's a very common technique used on mute guitar to give it a stereo width. You see the kick is running through Little Lab's Voice of God, or whatever it's called, VOG. You know, I don't even know the back end to that. Some people think it's just an EQ. Whatever it does it well, and it adds a lot of body to kicks and 808s as well. Here's without it. Very weak. And that almost made it a kick, you know, just adding that plugin alone. So it just shows the power of that plugin by itself. It made a kick that was very thin and weak sound like an actual kick. And let me pull up some of the subtle elements that you just might not have heard, like horns. Here's another synth. That was tucked in the back so you couldn't hear it. Let me turn off the gibberish track. So very simple, and then we have another percussion element coming in over here. With the bongos or congas, whatever. With this, all I know. Okay, hush. Now I'm muting the loud elements so you can hear what's actually going on in the background, like the bass, the piano. I'm going to mute those because those are obvious. Now another technique I did with the clap is in the pattern. I have one clap hitting on the first hit and then two claps hitting on the second hit. So it goes boom, psh, boom, psh, and then it's a little bit bigger on the second hit. So that creates like a disco effect. I learned that from disco music. Just little small time differences. Let's get back to the hook. I want to show you a couple more techniques in the hook and then show you in MIDI how I created the chords. So let's go back to the hook. So again, I like to do a lot of harmony style takes. So I did, you know, two main takes with three takes each. So I have left, right, and then center for each. And these are just, you know, slightly detuned from each other. but I ran it through auto-tune, so it pulls the pitch back together, but there's still audio flaws in the pitch.
Brand new, I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new, brand new, brand new. I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my...
Two different takes. So that's how you get that kind of chorusing sound. You can use plugins, but what I like to do is actually do another take. It just feels more authentic. There are plugins to create the chorus effect and kind of stereoize a mono sound, but I found that this is my way of doing it. You can use, like I said, a doubler from Waves to kind of spread it without overkill. So here's the center.
Brand new, I like my girls brand new. This is what we...
You can hear auto-tune pitch correcting, but that's fine because we have three different takes with those small flaws. So everything feels like chorusing rather than a flaw.
Brand new, I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new, brand new, brand new. I like...
And I also didn't take out the breaths.
Brand new, I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new, brand new, brand new. I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new, brand new.
It was brand new. So I hit the wrong note on one take, but that's fine because we have two other takes compensating for that pitch variation. Now let's listen to the harmony.
Brand new. Brand new.
Now you can really hear the breaths, but with, you know, as a song, I didn't edit out the breaths to even check, but just with the breaths, it fills in those gaps. It makes it feel more real. You know, that noise, that that air, that breath makes it feel less digital. And that's the kind of vibe I was going for. And that's why I'm going to show you where I used an aux verb to create a room kind of environment.
Brand new, brand new. We gon' do brand new.
So here on track 100, we have our aux verb, which is a dedicated track for effects. And I have the altiverb 7 loaded there. Basically, I'm running, you know, the majority of the sounds through that reverb. So if you look at hook 3, or if you look at any instrument, it's running through that reverb, you know, at different amounts. Okay, so everything's running through this reverb. It's a hall reverb sample in there. So we get a nice tall sound.
Brand new, brand new, we gonna do.
Because I learned from a sound designer in film, he said, you know, excuse me, I'm trying to think of the context he used. He said sounds in digital or synthesized sounds don't sound real because they're so clean and they don't have like a reverb. They don't have like an environment that they live in. They're just kind of sounds. And the difference between, you know, real sounds and synth sounds is that we can hear sounds in different positions. So we can use our echolocation strategies of our brain to figure out where sounds are coming from. And that's one technique, is to add reverb to make things feel real, even if they're synthesized. I even saw a video recently from a high-level producer. I forget who exactly. I would quote him, but he said, you know, he runs his synth kicks and synth snares through convolution reverb and then resamples it because he wants it to feel like it's a real thing coming from a real place rather than just hitting you out of nowhere as a frequency. Okay, so these are all things you want to think about. So that's why I added reverb.
Brand new. Brand new, we gon' do. Brand new, brand new, brand new, we gon' do. Brand new, brand new.
So I'm just repeating the main words. Okay, so let's hear it all.
I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new. Brand new, brand new. I like my girls brand new. This is what we gon' do. I like my girls brand new. Brand new.
Okay, so now this take was different, so it had a little more chest resonance, and it also didn't run it through a certain plugin that I ran the main hook through. Okay, so it had a cleaner response, but also a little more bass. So now let's, you know, run the hook back once, and then I'll get into the chords, and we're going to wrap it up.
Brando, I like my girls Brando, this is what we gon' do. I like my girls Brando, Brando, Brando. I like my girls Brando, this is what we gon' do. I like my girls Brando, Brando, Brando. I like my girls Brando, this is what we gon' do.
So I'll put this track on YouTube once it's done. I'm not going to do a verse for it. I'm just going to, you know, upload the instrumental with the hook for artists. But, oh, let me show you the chords before I forget. So to create the chords, it's a simple. So for this project, I don't have the MIDI because I recorded it into audio. But here's the technique I used for the chords to make them feel more islandy, if that's a word. So let me see here. Now, I don't have my MIDI controller turned on, so I'm just going to show you how to draw it out on the keyboard either way. So you're going to be playing it this way either way. So let me...
Brando, I like...
Okay, so we started up here. So the top note was going to be A. Now, of course, you have the rhythm, so that's pretty obvious. Notice the note lengths as well. Okay, so now we have the rhythm in place. I'm going to show you how I created the main chord. Now we use the A natural minor scale, which is all the white notes. So instead of using... So anyway, in our music theory essentials package, we have a technique called the pseudo leading tone. And what you can do is use the pseudo leading tone, or the tone that you hear in your head. You can use that tone to actually reverse engineer and build a chord using, what you know, different techniques. One of those techniques is our chord codes. So for example, in this case, actually it has nothing to do with the chord code, it has to do with the scale. So if A was the top note of a chord and we're talking about a triad, that chord triad would be D minor, because it's D, F, A. A would be the top note, D would be the root note. But instead of using the root note D, we're going to drop it down one key, that rhymed, to C. Okay, so let's drop it down from D to C. So now we have more of an island vibe instead of like a predictable vibe. So here's D minor. It just sounds basic. So let's pull it down to C. Now this key sound, this keyboard sounds a little bit different because I think it has detuning. Turn that off. Okay, so now we have it off. So that's the strategy here. So we're doing that for all the chords. So if it's B, the top note of B would be E minor if we're using A natural minor scale. But instead of E, we're using D. Now what this really is F A C inverted. So it's an F major inverting the fifth, or you could say that it's a D minor 7, but leaving out D. Okay, so D, it'd be D, F, A, C, and then we're inverting the C, but we're dropping out the D. So technically, if you wanted to name it properly, it'd be an F major inverting the fifth down an octave. So that's really what the chord is. So that's why it works. There's a reason why this works. There's a musical reason why this sounds good, and we go over that in our course called Chord Magic at busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic. That's just one technique of many, inversions. So we used inversions for all the chords. So here, EGB became, we're going to drop the E down to D. Same thing. We're just dropping the root note down to the note below it in the scale. So C would be F, A, C. But instead of F, we're going to play E. And this is the same chord. And that's how you get that kind of islandy vibe. So you can use that technique to create lighter chords. It's a different way of thinking about chords. Instead of boring classic triads, you can spice up the triad by, you know, using those inversions. So again, if you want to learn more about chords and scales and all that type of stuff, go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. We have free videos for you there. Or you can click that link below the video. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com, and this instrumental with a hook should be up soon to our YouTube page. So thanks for watching. It's Busyworks Beats.